Welcome to NDG Group. We are excited about getting started in the Word of God tonight. And I would like to confess that we've been coming before you on Tuesdays, Fridays, and also on Sundays. And our purpose has been to, since the pandemic, to impact the lives of our family. All of you know that I have 11 children, 8 or 9, maybe even 10 grandchildren. And we, because of the pandemic, we want to impact the lives of our family. Some of our natural family are living in various other states. And so we want to, and being the spiritual leader of my family, we found a way in which we could share the Word of God, because we realize that we don't know exactly when the situation is going to be different, but we not only want to impact the lives of our family, but we also want to take the opportunity to impact the lives of those that might follow us. We are non-denominational in the sense that we are not following, we are following the Word of God. We are not following religion, which I've shared with you that religion is man's attempt to reach God. And I can support that with Scripture. And denomination, you know, one of the questions that you need to ask is, what denomination was Jesus? And as you think about that, so we wanted to impact, because of the pandemic and we were quarantined, we found a way in which we could share the Word of God, not only with our families, but perhaps we could impact the lives of other families. And mainly is that because I was in prison, I have a deep heart and a yearning to open the eyes of those that sit in prison in the blindness of the situations that they're in, not seeing that there is a way, because I was in that situation once, but it was the Word of God that brought me out of that situation. So we, not just for my family, but for those that are in prisons. And sometimes I find that it's not just a physical prison, but there are many people that are still imprisoned. Prisons in their mentalities, prison in their minds, prison in their emotions, prisons in their desires. And so therefore, we took this opportunity to share. We are not professionals in this. As a matter of fact, I have my sons and my wife to assist us in doing these things, because we bring it to you, the Word of God. Because we believe that the Word of God is the answer for not only the pandemic, it's the answer for everything in this world. And we are accustomed to spending a great deal of time talking about the Word of God. But now people per se they want it instantly. They want to hear the answer instantly, and so forth and so on. So we have taken the opportunity to utilize methods like Kingdom Purpose TV. We come on Fridays at 8 o'clock. You know, we take a certain segment to try and share the Word of God. We are reaching people that are in Uganda. We are reaching people in West Africa. We are reaching people, amen, in other states. So therefore, we're going to continue doing what we're doing. And I just want you to bear with me. And I want you to keep in mind that we are not accustomed to doing this. We are not professionals. We are learning as we go along. And I want to go before the Lord in prayer. And I want you to be patient with me. And I want you to also go to YouTube and look over some of the videos that we have. Because we are not doing this for fame or fortune. We're doing this because we desire to impact the lives of our family, your family, and those that are in prison, and whosoever will. So tonight we want to go before the Lord in prayer. And Father, we thank you for this opportunity that we could share your word. We stand not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ, for we know it's the power of God unto salvation to everyone that believeth. And Lord God, we are praying, dear God, that you would open up the hearts and minds of those that might hear the word, that they might receive it, oh God, so that you can impact their lives like you have impacted my life and the lives of those in our families and your family, and that we might impact this world. We are to be called out of darkness into your marvelous light. And we thank you for this opportunity. We praise you for who you are and what you have done and what you are doing right now as we speak. We thank you, dear God. You said in everything, give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning us. We thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name we do pray. And those that are not ashamed say, in Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
We pray. Amen and amen. So, tonight, I want to, for the time that we do have, I want to talk about plans and purpose. And I want to go to a scripture that was written by the wisest man that ever lived, Solomon. And it perhaps might impact, because it was the wisest man, it might impact your life to understand that wisdom spoke this. And what he said is that there are many devices in a man's heart. Now, I'm going to take my time and make sure that you, those of you that desire to understand this, can understand it. And I'm going to not get excited about it. Oftentimes, I do get excited. And if I get excited, just hold my horse or my mule while I shout. Because, see, it's the word of God that should make us, amen, excited, because God said it. Amen. We don't have to have music. Remember, I know that music works on your feelings, but the word of God works on your inner man. Amen. So the Bible says there are many devices. Now, the word devices is plans. And some of the translations use the exact word plan. So there are many plans in a man, mankind's heart. Now, when we speak of heart, we are not talking about the one that pumps blood. We are talking about the one that sits between your two ears. That's the heart of the matter. That's your mind. And remember, I've often shared and will continue to share the fact that the Bible teaches us that our heart, keep your heart with all diligence. So you've got to be careful of things that you hear. You got to be careful about things that you see. And you got to be careful about things that you say. Because remember, the Bible says life and death is in the power of the tongue. And you're going to eat life, or you're going to speak death, or you're going to enjoy life, or you're going to enjoy death, because it comes from, amen, from what you see, from what you say, and that's the heart of the matter. We got two parts to our heart. We got a conscience part, what things that we are conscious of. And we have a subconscious, which is below our conscience. That's things that you'll never forget. Whatever you see, whatever you read, whatever you hear will be implanted into your subconscious mind. And right now, I could take you back to your kindergarten class, and I guarantee you that you've never thought of your kindergarten class for years, but those of you that are listening, I bet you could remember somebody in your kindergarten class. You could remember the teacher of your kindergarten class, you know, because we deal with the things that are implanted in our subconscious mind. Oftentimes, we even take drugs to try to drown out the consciousness of our surroundings, you know, because we only want to do things, touch things and see things and feel things that we desire. So the Bible is saying to us as believers, there are many devices in a man's heart. See, deep down in you, because the Bible says, out of the abundance of the mouth, out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. Sometimes we say things from our heart. You know, it comes from your subconscious. You know, and oftentimes it sometimes slips out because sometimes you're in an environment, amen, and in that environment, it might not be a good environment, and pretty soon something will slip out from the environment you're in because of it's in your heart. You know, so we have to pay attention to, amen, our heart, because the Bible says to us, it says, there are many devices in a man's heart. See, many plans. You've got many, many plans, many, many decisions that you make of what you want and what you need and what you are. It says, nevertheless, the counsel, the wisdom of the Lord, the counsel of the Lord that shall stand. And that's what I want to talk about tonight for a period of time. And as I said, I'm really intending to take my time in dealing with it, because I want you to understand and I want you to know that when God created man, he created man with a purpose. He created us, you and I, with a purpose. And that purpose was because God is sovereign. God knows everything. God has all power, and God is omnipresent, and he rules the world. And everything that was created for his purpose, and it was created for his glory. He didn't create anything that wasn't for his purpose or for his glory. And I want to prove to you, because I want to go to the book of Revelation, the 4th chapter, and we want to look at the 11th verse. And I want you to see exactly what it says in Revelation 4:11. It says, thou art worthy, O Lord, to receive glory and honor and power, for thou hast created all things. So my brother, my sister, my friend, you were created, amen, with a purpose. You were created for a purpose. And the Bible says, thou hast created all things. That means me, you. And for thy pleasure they were created. Amen. So for thy pleasure they are and were created. It was for the pleasure. God wanted, amen, for us to live down here upon this earth, just like a man in heaven. God wants us to live down on this earth. He come to create earth and establish earth with mankind so that we could live down here and be in right relationship with him. That was the purpose that God created. It was for his glory. Amen. Not for your glory, but God loves us. That's the one thing that you've always got to remember. God loves me. God loves you. And don't let anyone tell you that God doesn't. God loves you. And he has a purpose for you. He has a plan for your life. He has a plan for my life. Okay, so when God created us, and I want you to understand that, he had a purpose when he created us. And it was for his pleasure and for his glory. I want you to go to the book of Ecclesiastes and see another phrase. And I wish I had the time, I'd go down through the verse and we'd talk about it. Because I'm giving you what the word of God says. In Ecclesiastes, the 3rd chapter, in the 1st verse, he said, to everything there is a season of time. You know, we got 4 seasons. And they come. Amen. He say, and a time to every purpose under heaven. Now, he's not talking about above heaven, because God is in eternity. Amen. He comes in time, but God himself is in eternity. He exists in eternity, but he creates a time, and in that time, amen, he says, for every purpose that's under the sun. Now, I want you to understand that when God created man in the Garden of Eden, you know that there was Adam and there were Eve. God created them. They had a purpose in the creation that God created. You know that the Bible says in the book of Genesis, the Bible says that when he created everything, he said it was good. So there's nothing bad that God created. God said it was good. And then after he created man, he said it is very good. So he qualified the goodness when he created Adam, and he brought Eve out of Adam, and he brought them to enjoy. And that's what we are, to enjoy the earth that God has already created. He put man and woman to enjoy everything that God, amen, created for our enjoyment, for our pleasures. And he only put one thing that they could not do. They could do anything that they wanted, but one thing. And oftentimes, those that do not understand the Word of God, because see, there are people that still believe that all black people are cursed, and they use scriptures to justify that. That's stupidity. And it's time that we, as believers, get into the Word of God and understand the purpose and the plans that God have, because I want you to know that purpose is the existence or the originality of what God intends for that thing. Mankind, you know, that's the reason that birds do what? Birds fly. If a bird doesn't fly, it's not created for, it's not obeying what it was created for. Fishes swim. Why do they swim? Because that's what they were created for. And seeds grow plants. Every time you open up an apple, there's seeds in it. You replant that seed, and then there is another apple tree. And there is, so in every seed there's an orchard. And I don't want to get into talking about this, but I want you to know that you, my brother, my sister, my friend, you were created for a purpose. The purpose is already in you. What God wants. Amen. So when God had created Adam and Eve, he had a relationship with them. And that's what I want to tell you. Not religion, not a denomination, but it's a relationship. And God wants us to get back to that relationship where God talks to us and we talk to God. And I could pause a minute and tell you why is prayer meetings in the church, nobody wants to go to prayer meetings. Nobody wants to go. And when we go for all-night prayer, we take pillows. Why? Because we're planning on going to sleep. You know. But I want to talk about that. I want to talk about the purpose of things. Amen. Because God has a purpose, and he wants to communicate with Adam and Eve. And he did communicate with Adam and Eve. You know, the Bible says that he would walk in the cool of the day, and he would began to talk with Adam, and he would talk to Eve. My friend, my brothers and sisters, he wants to talk to you, just like he wants you to talk to him, because that's what communication, and that's what prayer is, communing, amen, with the one that spoke this world into existence. But I want to let you know something, and I want you to see this, and I want to go to the scriptures to kind of make you or help you to understand, amen, that when God created Adam and Eve, this was just for this kingdom down here on this earth. This was for this kingdom. God owns everything in the entire universe, all of the planets, all of the stars, and he owns everything. But he created a Eden for mankind to dwell in. But I want you to know that there was that relationship, and what broke that relationship. God gave man dominion. And we're going to get to that, but I want to first of all go to, well, let me just show you the dominion when God created man, what he gave him. Let's go to the book of Genesis, the first chapter in the 26th verse, because it tells you that God said, now this is God, let us make man in our image. So man is made in the image of God, after our likeness, and he say, let them, the ones that he created, which was Adam and Eve, have what? Dominion. Dominion is, I'm giving you the power to control everything that I have created, over the fish of the sea, over the fowl of the air, and over the cattle, and over all the earth. So mankind was given dominion, amen, to occupy earth, in behalf of God that spoke the world into existence, and the man that created, amen, mankind. And he said, over every creeping thing that creepeth upon the earth. Let's go to the next verse. And the next verse says, so, now here, so God created man in what? His own image. Amen. So you are a likeness of God. I am a likeness of God. Spiritually. Not naturally, but spiritually. Because God created man from the dust of the earth. He formed the dust of the earth. Amen. And he breathed into it, and man became a living soul. So man is a threefold. He's spirit. He has a soul that lives in a body. And the body is an earth body or a dirt body living on earth. And it's animated, amen, by the Spirit of God. So, in the image, in his own image. So you are, my brother, my sister, you are in the image of God. And in the image of God created him, male and female. So he made a male and he made a female, he created them. I don't want to deal with that right there. Let's go to the next verse. One of these days I'm going to deal with that. You probably know how I think about that. Amen. So God blessed them. He blessed them. Amen. Male and female. And let me say this as I'm passing by that. Do you know to be made a male or female is a chance? Whenever a seed is introduced, amen, the seed, amen, the sperm cell finds the womb and a baby comes forth. But it's a 50-50 chance of whether it will be male or whether it would be female, as far as I know. But a man is a choice. To be a woman is a choice, but that's the purposes. It's a 50-50 chance whether you're going to be a man or whether you're going to be a woman, but your man is a choice. You know, you put the two and two together. You know, you're either a man or you are a woke man. That's by choice. Amen. Some people don't believe in choices, you know, but chance is 50-50, but choice is a decision that must be made, amen, to fulfill the purpose that you were created for. There are many people that are not walking in their purpose, you know. So therefore, he gave them dominion over the fish of the sea, over the fowl of the air, and over everything that moveth upon the earth. Now, quickly, I want you to go to Genesis 1:1. Because I want you to see that in Genesis 1:1, the Bible says, in the beginning, God. In the beginning, God. It doesn't say when it was. It doesn't say where it was. It doesn't say what year was the beginning. But it lets us know one thing. Whenever there was a beginning, there was a God. You can go back much further than roots. You can go back, amen, much further than the Garden of Eden. Because in the beginning, God. Sometimes some of the Islamic believers, the Muslim, teach 66 trillion years ago. But the Bible say, in the beginning, God created heaven and the earth. We can rest assured that there was a plan, there was a purpose. And I want you to see in the next verse what God says. Because I want you to understand this, and I want you to search this. And the Bible says, and the earth was without form and void. Well, I want you to know that that's a period of time from Genesis 1 to Genesis 1:2. It covers a period of time because we have studied the scriptures, and the scripture says that everything that God makes was good. All of a sudden, it was void. There's a reason for the voidness. And we are not able to continue talking about the voidness now. But I will make sure that we go and have a man about the voidness so you can understand the purposes of God. I want to pray with you tonight. Heavenly Father, we thank you, dear God, for the opportunity to share scriptures. Amen. And I pray that our understandings be enlightened to know that you have a plan and purpose for every person upon the face of this earth. We thank you, dear God, for the opportunity that we could, Lord, somehow open up blinded eyes. Somehow we could bring your spirit into the spirits of those that might hear the word and receive the word with meekness, that you might be able to save their soul. These things we do ask in Jesus' precious name we pray. God bless you and keep you is our prayer.